Jeopardy. Today's contestants are a business intelligence consultant from Casca, Minnesota, Connie Arnis.
Do a six-pack with six in quotation marks. All right, Carlos.
Animated movies by character, 200, please.
2001, Donkey. Cecilia.
What is Shrek?
Yep.
What is Shrek?
Women in History for 200.
She said of refusing to give up her seat, the only tired I was tired of giving in.
Who was Rosa Parks?
Miss Rosa Parks.
Correct.
Animated movies, 400, please.
1967, Shere Khan, a tiger. Carlos?
What is The Jungle Book?
The Jungle Book?
Animated movie, 600.
1991, Gaston. Carlos?
What is Beauty and the Beast?
Yep.
Animated movies, 800.
2004,
oh, Elastigirl. Beauty and the Beast.
Carlos?
What is The Incredible?
Almost at it.
I hate tubes. I'll be damned if I'm going to spend the next... A zombie boy looks half dead already.
You can't have your own room. It would be an enormous PR problem.
I don't give a shit anyway. I still want my own room. It's my hospital, for Christ's sakes. Don't tell me I can't have my own room. No offense.
You publicly defended this policy countless times. I run hospitals, not health spas. Two beds to every room, no exceptions.
I've never been sick before.
Okay. Dr. Han will be up here in a minute to set you up.
Set me up? Oh, Jesus, Thomas. Don't let me wake up paralyzed.
I'll do what I can. The doctor said that you're going to undergo some experimental treatments. Quadratic equation.
Is this really his hospital?
Pretty much.
Might want to do something about the pea soup.
What is a quadratic equation, anyway?
Chemo?
How rough is it?
Nothing bad if you don't mind around-the-clock vomiting, watching your veins turn black, and feeling like your bones are made of napalm.
Ah, a stroll in the park. That's a relief.
Well, all sorts of people react to it differently. You'll know by tonight.
Tonight?
Listen, let me ask you something. What is that contraption you got over there?
It's a craftier. It makes coffee.
What else does it do?
What else does it have to do?
Did you know that coffee was originally discovered by a shepherd in Ethiopia?
It's true. It seems the goats were eating berries from an unfamiliar bush, and not for long they were jumping all over the place, having a gay old time. So the shepherd took some branches to the local monastery, where the abbess decided to roast them. And the berries started to burn, and the beans inside gave off a very pleasant aroma. They brewed them into a stew.
Stew, huh?
And over the next 100 years, it spread to Arabia, Europe, and to Sumatra. Like that pooch over there.
It's called Kopi Luwak.
I know what it's called.
You do? I wouldn't drink that shit.
Well, have you ever tried it?
No, I'm more of an instant coffee man.
Edward? Edward?
What?
How's it going there?
dumb question.
Well, I have your test results back.
Oh, straight out, huh?
Let's see. 6 months. A year, if we're lucky.
Oh.
There is a really good experimental program that I would like to get you on, but I don't want to get your hopes up. I think you would make the perfect candidate.
Hey, Doc. I'm watching television. You're blocking the view.
Oh, sorry. You know, Edward, if you ever have any questions for me, day or night, you know where to find me.
One question.
Of course.
Carter, don't you have a question for Dr. Horn here?
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm unfamiliar with his chart.
Well, get familiar.
I just want to know how I stand, that's all.
Sure. I'm gonna go get your chart.
Thank you. Hey, Edward. Edward. You know, there was a survey once. 1,000 people went asked if they could know in advance what they wanted to know the time of their deaths. I always leaned kind of toward the other 4%. I always thought it'd be kind of liberating not knowing how much time we had left to work with. It turns out it's not.
What's this?
What? It would be Thomas, sir.
What was that, Thomas? What was that?
Sir, I don't mean to sound indelicate. I was just wondering how you would like for me to handle your...
My death? Treat it as if it were your own.
So, leave all the money to my assistant?
And don't buy any green bananas. Yeah, so what is this?
What are you doing?
Oh, what is it?
Come on, give it back.
Well, it was lying on the floor. I didn't think it was a state secret.
Oh, well, my freshman philosopher assigned this exercise in forward thinking. It's called the bucket list. We're supposed to make a list of all the things we want to do in our lives before we kick the bucket.
Cutesy.
So I wrote down some things like make $1 million, the first Black president, you know, young man's wishes. But now it's done. I was trying to redo it, but
help a complete stranger for the good. Laugh until I cry. Not to be judgmental, but this is very weak.
Well, it's pointless now.
I would argue the exact opposite. Just a little rewrite, that's
all. What are you doing?
Just a little rewrite. I mean, don't you want to go out with some balls, guns blazing? Have a little fun.
It's not supposed to be about guns blazing, anything like that.
No, you're missing the point. What the hell is with do something majestic.
Have you ever been to the Himalayas? Drive a Mustang Shelby?
I've got one.
How about skydiving?
Now we're on to something.
We're on to something? Let me see that. Kiss the most beautiful girl in the world? How you propose doing that?
volume.
Get a tattoo. Is that the sum of your ambition? Edward, I've taken baths deeper than you. It's easy to be deep and fresh in philosophy. What did Dr. Hahn say? How much time we got left?
A year, maybe.
You think 45 years went by fast?
We can do this. We should do this. Now listen, no, don't even think about the money. I never think about money. That's all I have is money.
But I don't know if I can go and
know what? What don't you know?
I just have to get familiar with it. That's
what you don't know is that it was meant to be metaphorical.
I just can't seem to get a handle on this thing.
Blah, 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 blah. Metaphorical. You're the one who's crying that you never had a chance to grab some adventure in life. Here's your chance.
Chance to what? Make a fool of myself?
Never too late.
So what's it we're supposed to do now?
What happens now? Well, now I go back to sitting around and listening to people talk about mezzanine financing and subordinating debt, pretending that I care about death money. And you go home to some ceremonial procession about your death, with everybody standing around watching you die while you're trying to comfort them. Is that what you want? To be smothered with pity and grief? Well, not me. And in your heart, Carter, I believe not you either. We're both in the same boat. How's that for a metaphor? We've got a real opportunity here.
Opportunity? That's a real twist even by your standards.
You still feel good, right? Energy's coming back a little bit. Asymptomatic, the doc says. The way I see it, we can lie around here hoping for a miracle with some bullshit science experiment. Or we could put some moves on.
Skydiving, huh? Virginia, we gotta talk.
What did they say?
It's not good.
Mrs. Chambers. Mrs. Chambers, I'm gonna give you two a little quiet time. Excuse me.
Carter, what did they say?
Sweetheart, it's not good.
I knew we should have went to UCLA. The surgeons are better.
It wouldn't have made any difference.
You don't know that. And we're not giving up. I want another opinion.
Hold on, Virginia.
Yes? Oncology, please. Dr. Peach's office.
Virginia, no.
Let me handle this. Dr. Petrus is Virginia Chambers. Yes, that's right.
I'm going away for a while.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about Edward and I are going away.
Edward and you are going away. Where?
Well, I didn't expect you to understand.
Listen, you damn right I don't understand. I don't understand. How can you just give up like this? How can you just quit? Quit fighting.
Quit fighting? Virginia, why are you saying I'm
not
going to quit?
Why don't you tell our children that and see what they say when they find out that you just gave up on them?
Giving up on them? I spent 45 years beat up under the hood of a car so they didn't have to. And they didn't. And I think I've earned some time for myself.
To do what? Run off with a total stranger?
He's not a stranger.
I'm your wife.
And I'm your husband. And I'm their father. And I'm a grandfather. And I'm a damn mechanic.
And you're a fool. You're a fool who thinks he's figured out a way how to not have cancer. Oh, wait. I'm sorry. My husband is not for sale.
She hates me. You hate me?
Not yet. And so it began. You know, I always wondered what it would be like to go up in an airplane, because I was always afraid of that. But now, I'm gonna go up in one on the whim of a maniac?
Just a small town girl, living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere.
By the morning of his surgery, the cancer had spread so far that the doctors had only given him about a 5% chance to survive. But then again, they didn't take into account just how pissed off they'd made him.
Wait a minute. What am I doing up here? Wait!
Are you ready, Carter?
No! Wait!
Wait! One, two, three!
Oh! I hate the right gun!
Don't mention it, lover boy!
Oh, which one of these damn cords do you pull?
Streetlights.
Edward was not a man to just take whatever life threw at him. Oh no, his will, his intestinal fortitude was on full display for everyone to see. Jumping out of a plane was just one of many ventures. His way of giving death the finger.
Tommy, we live to die another day.
How lucky for me.
No jokes, Tommy. Remember the will. You're this close.
Let me ask you something. Is it Tommy or Thomas?
Actually, it's Matthew, but he finds that too biblical.
Is he insane?
It depends.
Well, so did you decide on a tattoo?
No, I couldn't think of anything I wanted to be permanently attached to.
What do you mean, permanently? We're going to be dead in 5 minutes.
What?
Oh, it's just a figure of speech. So, what do you think? No Confederate flag? No black Jesus?
Jerusalema, ikayalami, ilondoloze, uhambe nami, zumangishilana, Jerusalema, ikayalami.
It was amazing to watch these two men bond, becoming closer and closer every day. More than friends, more than family. Two men with destinies intertwined. Laughing and playing, joking and acting like big kids. Their respect growing from one another. Two men, acting like boys. Living as they were dying.
No, man, I don't think that's a good one right there.
Oh, yeah, sure. A woman, that's it. An actress. It's a tattoo. It's not like you're dumping her for another woman.
I've never been with another woman.
Oh, now that has got to go on the list.
No way.
We ought to have a big orgy.
No.
An orgy is not even being unfaithful. How do you like the tattoo? Parting is such sweet sorrow. Shakespeare.
Yeah. Don Omar. J-Doe. Rick the Villain. Bust a bus.
Exactly how we rollin' and we huggin' every block. No matter how police
patrolling and we do it how we do it, whether it's now or it's later, and we always handle business cause we bout getting this paper. What you want, what you need, as we walk through every gutter, every hood, and every street, and every block, we got it covered, throwing money while we in the club with shorties on the pole. Let's get it popping in this bitch, me get my click.
It's difficult to understand the sum of a person's life. Some people would tell you it's measured by the ones left behind. Some believe that it can be measured in faith. Some say by love. And other folks say life has no meaning at all. Me, I believe that you measure yourself by the people who measure themselves by you.
Choose. I get up in that bed and started, all you hear is roaring up the engine till it pop like a balloon.
Well, here she is. How do you like her?
Hello, darling.
Are you gonna drive her or buy her a dress?
Just getting to know each other, that's all. Are you sure we're cleared for this?
Of course we're cleared for this. What if we weren't?
Just checking.
Ladies and gentlemen,
let's see how she handles.
May I have your attention, please? The race.
She knows what he likes and how he likes it. Yeah. Okay, what's next? I'm going down the list here. Do you have his coffee maker? Oh, God forbid if you don't have his coffee. You know how he is if he doesn't have his coffee. I made the arrangements. What do you mean it's not there? I put it... Okay. All right. Oh, thank goodness. All right. Well, they're going to be here soon. Okay.
Alright, I'll talk to you later. You can do like you do, or you can do like me. Stay in the cage or you finally take the key. Oh damn, suddenly you're free to fly. It'll take you to the other side.
How much money do you have anyway?
Hasn't anybody ever told you it's rude to talk about other people's money?
I never knew anyone with enough to ask.
We're flying over the polar cap, home of desolation.
The stars are really one of God's greatness.
So you really think some being did all of this?
You don't?
We live, we die, and the wheels on the bus go round and round.
Well, what if you're wrong?
I would love to be wrong. If I'm wrong, I win.
I'm not sure if it works that way, Edward. Edward, you never mention your family hardly. How's your daughter?
She hates me. I haven't seen her in years.
What?
She blames me for destroying her marriage.
Why? What happened?
Well, I found out that her husband hit her, so I did what any decent father would do. I whooped his ass. Then he moved out. She said that it wasn't his fault that he got drunk and he was really a nice person. She stopped taking my calls, moved away, told me I was dead to her.
Oh, I'm very sorry. Well, we're putting it on the list. It's time.
No. Cross it off the list.
Why?
I said no, and there is no why.
Well, what's the matter?
Nothing, Carter. Let's just not ever mention her again. That's life in the big city.
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail, I'm the master of my sea. Oh,
hi. Yeah, there's been a change in plans. We're going to be in New York. Yeah, we're actually here now. I know we were supposed to be in Paris, but I had a cousin who had a friend who had another friend who had a cousin who had a mother-in-law who had a brother-in-law who had a sister and a daughter, and she was able to talk to the Schuberts, and they got us a Broadway stage. Yeah, they put it on their bucket list. They wanted to dance on Broadway, and I was able to make it happen. Who's the best assistant ever? Yeah, I know. But we're not going to be in Paris like we were supposed to be. We're still coming, but we're just coming a little later. So I can't talk long. I gotta go because I got to give them their cue, you know? Yeah, I know. They're going to dance for a whole, like, live audience before the show starts. I know. It's so good. Okay, I got to run. Take care. Okay, bye-bye. All right, guys, take it away.
And meet those dancing feet on the avenue I'm taking you to, 42nd Street. Hear the beat of dancing feet. It's the song I love, the melody of 42nd Street. Little nifties from the 50s, innocent and sweet. Sexy ladies from the 80s who are indiscreet. They're side by side, they're glorified. Where the underworld can meet the elite. Second Street.
Boy, one button low. Wait, you know I'm sharp as a tack. Feeling your Cadillac. Gotta go to the party. Yeah, please lend me your shoulder. Well, if you can't take it, you know can't make it. I won't see my baby no more.
Trickle, trickle, splash, splash. Tell me how long this thing lasts.
From the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the.
All right, it took some doing, but I rearranged everything. Cairo tomorrow. Tanzania for 2 days, and Johannesburg on Saturday. Yeah, and as directed, no tiger hunts and no bullfights. Yeah, got it. Okay, I'm on it. Thanks.
Choosing your battles, pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's off, you feel it, but you got it all, believe it. When you fold, get up, oh, oh, and if you fold, get up, eh, eh. Tamina, mina, sangalewa, cause this is Africa. Tamina, mina, eh, eh. It's time for Africa. Listen to your God. This is our motto. Your time to shine. Don't wait in line.
Thomas. I would really like to say that you are irreplaceable. But I'd be lying.
I'd really like to say that you're a gracious man and that I love my job, but then I too would be lying.
Turnabout is fair play. I think you learned that from me fast. Hello?
Mr. Cole? Virginia Chambers.
Oh, yeah. Hi. Let me get Carter for you. He's on the other side here.
Well, actually, I called to speak to you.
Oh?
Is he all right?
Oh, yes. He's fine. He's doing fine.
Where are you?
France, actually. Tomorrow.
Edward, give him back to me.
Virginia. May I call you Virginia? I don't know that I can tell your husband.
I'm not asking for his sake, Mr. Cole. I've been a nurse my entire adult life. Had a ringside seat to more human tragedies than any woman should ever have to bear. Now, I'm prepared for my husband to die. I'm just not prepared to lose him while he's still alive. Give him back to me now.
Carter, I've been thinking maybe we should put this all on hold for a while.
I told you to stop worrying. I'm fine.
Oh, it's not that. It's not that. It's just maybe you're worried about letting me down. You know, it's a lot easier for me.
You talked to Virginia, didn't you? Why do you think I'm doing this?
Because I talked you into it.
Edward, you're strong, but not that strong. I'll go back when I'm ready to go back. Edward, have you found joy in your life? Answer the question.
Me answer the question, if I found joy in life.
Have you brought joy to other people's life?
Oh, these questions, I don't know.
When think about people, what gauge that gives them about you?
Ask them.
I'm asking you.
Right.
I want to go home.
Excuse me?
I want to go home now.
Call my name. Call my name. Heard your voice this morning. Calling out my name. It had been so long since I heard it, and it didn't really sound quite the same. But it let me know my name had never really been spoken before. Since the day you carried me across that bridal path door. And ever since that day I never wanted anyone. And anybody who really knows me knows the truth, that I just can't stop writing songs about you. I love you so much. I can't wait to get my arms around you and feel your touch. If I don't see you real soon, baby.
Say, Tommy, this is not the way to Crenchwich.
There's an accident on the 10, so we're taking the side roads.
What? Why? Oh, my God. This is my daughter's house. This is my daughter's house.
I decided to do that. Just in case you decide to go on your own or something.
This was your idea, Tommy?
No, it's my idea. I talked him into it.
You talked him into it. Tom, you know how I feel about this. What is wrong with you?
Edward, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Why are you so upset? What's going on with you?
Just because I told you my story does not invite you to be part of it. You have no frickin' idea who I am. I built a billion-dollar business up from nothing. Presidents ask my advice. I've dined with royalty. And I'm supposed to make out like this, what, this trip was supposed to mean something to me? Like it was gonna change me? How did you play it out, Carter? That I would knock on the door? She answers. She's surprised and angry. But I tell her how much I love her and miss her, and oh, by the way, I'm going to die soon. So I'm reaching out to you because I don't want to die alone.
Everyone's afraid to die alone.
I'm not everyone. This was supposed to be fun. That's all it ever was. Now you get out. Get out of my car. Get out. Call a cab.
Even sure we needed it. You know how long it's been.
Do I want to know?
Well, it's been longer than that.
You know, I feel like a teenager, like the first time.
If we were teenagers, we wouldn't have gotten out of the living room.
Oh, I remember the first time.
There was no tippy-toeing with you. Ooh. You were all over me like
thank you.
You look like shit.
Thanks.
How are they treating you?
The pea soup still sucks.
I'll have a talk with the owner.
You do that. You still drinking that fancy coffee?
Why? Are you possessed?
Read this.
Hopi Luwak is the world's most expensive coffee. Although some have said it falls under the category of too good to be true, in the Sumatra village where the beans are grown lives a breed of wild tree cats. These cats eat the beans, digest them, and then defecate. The villagers then collect and process the stools. It is a combination of the beans and the gastric juices of the tree cats that give Hopi Luwak its unique flavor and aroma. You're shitting me.
The cats made me do it. You got a pin. Give me a pin. Laugh until you cry.
It's not finished. This is not a one-man deal.
I'm afraid it has to be.
We're ready.
I'll be here when you get back.
That sounds good to me. My name is Edward Cole. I don't know what most people say in these occasions. In all honesty, I try to avoid them. The simplest thing is that I loved him, and I'll miss him. Carter and I saw the world together, and it's amazing when you stop to think that only 3 months ago, we were complete strangers. Help a complete stranger for the good. I hope it doesn't sound selfish of me, but the last 3 months of his life were the best 3 months of mine. He saved my life
and he knew about it even before I did. I am deeply proud that this man found it worth his while to know me in the end. And I think it's safe to say that we brought some joy into each other's life. So one day, when I go to my final resting place and wake by a certain wall with a gate, I hope that Carter is there to vouch for me and show me the ropes on the other side.
Edwin Paramount Cole died in May. It was on a Sunday afternoon, and there wasn't a cloud in the sky. He was 81 years old. Witness something majestic. Even now, I can't claim to understand the measure of a life, but I can tell you this. I know that when he died, his eyes were closed.
But his heart was open, and I'm pretty sure he was happy. Since his final resting place was right beside his good buddy Carter. Because he was buried on a mountain. That was against the law.
That was fantastic. What an excellent, excellent, excellent show, excellent performance. Like we always say, it just gets better and better and better. Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoyed this Incarn special live Zoom presentation of The Bucket List. And now, please get ready. Put your comments in below. Give them the applause, the claps they deserve. Please give our cast and our crew the round of applause they deserve. And at this point, I also want to let you know that the music that you heard, the piano and some of the solos, was by Cedric Mitchell. Cedric Mitchell is actually the one who had the music, whose music we were underscoring. So now, please put your hands together for Hannah Perka. He is so funny. Please put your hands together for J.D. Brookshire. Hazel Rebels. Gilmore. Tonight, our captions was by Ebony Ricketts and Hannah Perker. They were our captioners. So please give it up for our captioners. And now, Miss Michelle Hawkins Jones.
You know, when we're in rehearsal, we hear and see the stories over and over again. But they're just moments that you can't ignore. Those tearful moments, those moments of laughter, they are as fresh as the first day we started rehearsal. Want to thank the cast so much for just giving up their time and their energy. I'm sure you all enjoyed it. Please make sure you send them a special shout out to let them know how awesome they were. What we did not do is when we first started, we did not focus on the giving. So I'd like to just ask for you, if you are willing to donate to our church. It is Mount Pisgah Baptist Church. We're located at 212 Tompkins Avenue, and that's in Brooklyn, New York, 11216. The phone number there is 718-388-3900. You can go to Zelle at giving at mtpisgahny.org or Givelify and make sure you select Mount Pisgah in Brooklyn. If you'd like to cash app our bishop directly, his cash app is Johnny Ray Youngblood. You can check out our website for more information. And if indeed you really enjoy the extra talents that you experienced today, our team also has a way that you can give them a donation. And I believe we have a flyer for that as well. To Naima Brown, who did the music that I'm sure you all loved so much. To Daryl Copeland, who does our flyers. And to Kim Brothers, who's also in our background doing any and everything that we need. Wanna also ask that if you are interested in participating in our Ma'afa month, which is in February, and you'd like to commemorate or remember one of your loved ones who've transitioned, you can email us your picture of your family member or friend to incarnlvt@gmail.com. And during the month of February, we will have a special program where we'll be honoring all our ancestors, and we'd love to make sure your loved one is remembered as well. So with this, we want to know what that challenge was at the beginning, right? So what was the first thing they put on that bucket list? Skydiving. So we found a place in Long Island. That's only if you're in the New York area. If you're in Long Island or near Long Island and want to participate, some of our team members are daring. And I'm mentioning Kenya and Naima. I think Melisha Jones, they've all decided that they're going to go skydiving. So if that's on your bucket list, please let us know. We'll let you know when and where. I understand that the price, depending on how many go, will be between $200 or $300 if you get a video. If you want a picture of how you look on the ground, I'll be on the ground taking pictures. So please make sure you join us, put it on your bucket list, and if anything or anyone that you want to make sure you remember or acknowledge that you haven't, you need to do it now because tomorrow is not promised. Thank you so much
for joining us today. We'll see you next Sunday at 5. If our bishop would have anything to say, Bishop, you've got the floor.
Again, thank you. The Lord be with you all. I think that this was colossal. We're always kind of debating which one was the best. I'm going to vote for this one today because I'm in the bucket list territory. Good night. God bless all of you.
Thank you. All right, everyone, let's enjoy some music. Tell us what's on your bucket list in the chat. See you next Sunday.
Come on, put your hands together.
And as a part, as a follow-up.
Come on, put them together like this.
As a follow-up to the...
Yeah. Come on, y'all. We're going
to take it. Welcome. Come on.
They did awesome. Y'all were awesome.
Everyone didn't want to go.
That's just Virginia.
That's